Hey guys, we have free online textbook. Just click the link on the description below and you can access our vocabulary list, exercises, and listen to Japanese people speaking Japanese words and sentences to help you learn Japanese fast and easily. It's free!
Minasan, konnichiwa! Manabu no Jeffrey desu. I'm Jeffrey from Manabu. This is Lesson 2 Grammar Explanation. Let's begin. Dewa, hajimashou!
In this lesson, we will learn the following grammar points. So first grammar point is noun one wa, noun two desu. Noun one wa, noun two desu. This noun one is our topic of the sentence, followed by the particle wa. So this is called a sentence particle. The particle wa indicates the topic of the sentence. This sentence is about noun 1. We will describe noun 1. Next is noun 2 desu. Spelled as desu but is pronounced as desu. So noun 2 will be the predicate of the sentence. This will describe our subject, the noun 1. Take note that this particle is the character ha from the hiragana chart, but it is read as wa, because it is used as a particle. And also take note that desu shows politeness to the listener. Remember that there are levels of politeness in speaking Japanese, and this is one example, the desu. When we will say I am Jeffrey, if we follow the sentence pattern noun 1 wa noun 2 desu, so noun 1, we will use the word watashi. In English, I or me. So it means I will talk about myself, watashi, followed by the particle wa, to indicate that watashi is our topic. We will put the particle wa and then follow the noun to desu pattern. We will use a noun to describe our subject, the watashi. So I will use my name to describe watashi. So watashi wa Jeffrey desu. So Jeffrey is written using the katakana characters because Jeffrey is not a Japanese name. So just simply follow the sentence pattern noun 1 wa noun 2 desu. Watashi wa Jeffrey desu. Let's look at another example. Watashi wa kyoushi desu. Watashi wa kyoushi desu. So once again, watashi in English is I or me. So before we describe watashi using my name, I will describe myself that I am a teacher. So watashi wa kyoushi desu. About me, watashi, that watashi is a kyoushi. Let's look at another example. Not only we can describe ourselves, but we can describe other people. For example, we will describe Miss Janjel. Miss Janjel will be our subject. So we will write Janjel Sang. So this Sang is a name suffix. It's attached to a name of a person to show politeness. And this is also translated in English as Mr. or Miss. Then the name Janjel will be written using the katakana characters because she is not a Japanese. So Janjel-san, then followed by particle wa to indicate that Janjel-san is our subject. Or we will talk about Janjel-san. What is Janjel-san? She is sensei desu. Sensei desu. Sensei in English means a teacher. So sensei desu is a teacher. Let's proceed to our next grammar point. This time, we will have noun 1 wa noun 2 ja arimasen. Instead of desu, it becomes ja arimasen. Remember that ja arimasen is the opposite of desu. It means desu is positive and ja arimasen is the negative form. Ja arimasen or de wa arimasen. Ja arimasen is often used in conversation. And dewa arimasen is also used in conversation but in a formal speech and in written Japanese. So remember that ja arimasen will be translated into a word is not. So the negative form of this. Let's see the examples. Following the pattern nonwan wa noun to ja arimasen or dewa arimasen, we will describe again myself, watashi. Watashi followed by the particle wa to indicate that this sentence is about watashi, watashi wa. Then the noun to ja arimasen, isha ja arimasen. So it means if we translate this one by one, I, then isha ja arimasen is not a doctor. Next example. Now we will describe Mr. Van. So Van is not a Japanese name, so we will write his name using the katakana characters and we will attach or we'll put san in English, Mr. Van. Van san wa, Van is gakusei, student, but ja arimasen is not a student. Okay? Noun wan wa noun to desu ka? So remember that this sentence pattern is the same with our first grammar point, the noun wan wa noun to desu, but this time we added the particle ka. This is a question marker, so we will ask if the noun wan wa noun to desu is correct or not. Let's look at the example. So we followed noun wan wa noun to desu. Mr. Van is Amerikajin desu. Mr. Van is an American. So this word is a country name then followed by the suffix jin. Jin literally means person. Then if we attach it to America, it means that a person from America. Then we added ka, question mark. Is Mr. Van an American? So you can answer this type of question using yes or no. If you answered no, the word for no is iye. Then we will use the noun one wa noun to desu pattern to answer this kind of question. But in this case, we answered a negative. Iye means no, it's a negative. So we will use ja arimasen instead of desu. If you answered yes, yes in Japanese is hai. Then Amerikajin desu, an American. So iye Amerikajin ja arimasen, is not an American. Then you can follow with a correct answer. Kare wa, so kare in English means he. Then particle wa, then the noun to desu is Filipinjin desu. He is a Filipinos. So once again, the particle ka is added to a sentence to make it a question. Now we will use noun to as interrogatives. We will use the word dare. Dare in English is who. So we will describe that person. Ano hito. Ano hito. So ano hito wa, then this is noun to desu. Then we don't know that person, so we will ask dare desu ka? Who? So if we translate this one by one, ano hito wa that person, dare desu ka is who? Who is that person? So we will answer with a name. Mirton sang desu. Mirton is not a Japanese, so we will write it using the katakana characters. Then sang, Mr. Milton desu. So this sentence pattern is the noun one wa noun to desu. Then we can omit or remove ano hito wa because it is already implied in the question. Milton sang desu. It's Mr. Milton. Another example. Jeffrey sang wa nansai desu ka? So in this case, we use the interrogative nansai. Nansai in English is how old. So we want to ask about the subject, about his age. If we translate it one by one, Mr. Jeffrey is how old? So how old are you, Mr. Jeffrey? So we will answer the word nansai with our age. Watashi wa 28 desu. Watashi wa 28 desu. I'm 28 years old. Now let's proceed to our fourth grammar point. Noun one mo, noun two desu. Noun one mo, noun two desu. We will use the particle mo instead of the particle wa. Remember that mo is translated as the word also. Let's look at the example. In this example, there is a sentence 1. So remember that the subject in sentence number 1 and the subject in sentence number 2 have the same characteristics or the same noun 2. Like this, isang wa ento desu. So Mr. A is noun 2 and Mr. B is also noun 2. So this particle mo means that Mr. B is also the same with isang, he is noun 2. Let's look at the sentence example. So the sentence number 1 is noun 1 wa noun 2 desu. Jeffrey san wa sensei desu. Jeffrey san wa sensei desu. Mr. Jeffrey is a teacher. Then we followed it with sentence number 2. Janjiru san mo, instead of the particle wa, we use the particle mo because Janjiru san is also a teacher, is also a sensei, just like Jeffrey san. So we will use the particle mo because Janjiru san is also a teacher. Janjiru san mo sensei desu. Another example. Ban sang wa Philippine jin desu. Mr. Ban, ban sang wa Philippine jin desu, is a Filipino. So you will expect that the person described in the sentence number 2 is the same with ban sang, is also a Filipino. In this case, watashi mo. Watashi means I, then I am also Philippine jin desu, a Filipino. So our next grammar point is noun 1 no, noun 2 desu. So we will now have another particle, the particle no. So remember our particles that we have learned earlier, the particle wa, the particle mo, and now the particle no. We will use particle no to connect noun 1 to noun 2. So remember that there are a lot of uses of the particle no, but in this lesson, the first use of particle no is to express that noun 1 is an organization which the noun 2 belongs. So, noun 2 belongs to noun 1. For example, Tokyo Daigaku no sensei. Tokyo Daigaku no sensei. Tokyo Daigaku is an organization, a school, a group. Noun 2 is sensei, in English, teacher. We can translate it in English as a teacher at Tokyo University or a sensei that belongs to Tokyo University. Appuro no shain. Appuro no shain. In this case, the noun 1 is a company name. Appuro no shain. Yokohama Byouin no Isha. Yokohama Byouin no Isha. The noun 1 is a hospital. The noun 2 is Isha, doctor. A doctor of Yokohama Hospital. Yokohama Byouin no Isha. Let's compare noun 1 wa noun 2 desu. For example, Myrton san wa sensei desu or Myrton wa sensei desu. Mr. Milton is a sensei. So now we will use the particle no to be more specific, to add more description about Mr. Milton. So Myrton san wa, so this will be our noun 2. Myrton san wa Tokyo Daigaku no sensei desu. Mr. Milton is Tokyo Daigaku no sensei, a sensei or a teacher of Tokyo Daigaku. A teacher at Tokyo Daigaku. Another example is Josh wa Tokyo Daigaku no gakusei desu. Josh wa Tokyo Daigaku no gakusei desu. Josh is a student at Tokyo University. Our last Grammar point, the name suffixes sang, kun, and chang. Remember that we use the suffix sang to show politeness to the listener or to the person that we are talking about. It means Mr. or Miss. And this time, we will add kun and chang. For example, ano hitowa dare desu ka? Who is that person? Ano hitowa kurota sang desu. So to show politeness, we will use sang. It should never be used with the speaker's own name. So we will use sang to other person or the person we are talking to, not with our own name. So another example is BBN chang wa nansai desu ka? So instead of using the suffix sang, we use chang because BBN is a little girl. Then BBN will answer Juyong sai desu. I'm 14 years old. Chang is added to small children's name instead of sang. Remember, kun is added to little boy's name instead of chang. And kun is also used among close friends, among male friends, to indicate familiarity or closeness. So let's recap our grammar points. We learned noun one wa, noun to desu. Noun one wa, noun to ja arimasen. Noun one wa, noun to desu ka? Noun one mo, noun to desu. Noun one no, noun to desu. And the suffixes sang, kun, and chang.
Minasan, kyou no lesson wa ikaga deshita ka? I hope you learned a lot in today's lesson. If you have questions, you can leave a comment below. And also, you can follow me on my Instagram account. Please subscribe to our channel and hit that notification bell so you won't miss our future lessons. Dewa, mata ne. Bye-bye.
Hey guys, what's up? My name is Ben. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please hit the like button and leave us a comment down below. And if you want to learn more Nihongo, click the subscribe button and click the bell to be notified whenever we upload a new video. And if you want to know more about Manabu, just follow their page on Facebook and Instagram. Alright, see you on the next one. Ja, mata ne!